GS, we got some news, cool stuff to talk about today.
Yeah, a lot of cool things, like the weather.
Like the weather, it's hot.
It's not that, it's the opposite of cool.
Yeah, yeah, it's not great.
Yeah, it went from, we got a late start to summer, late start to spring and summer, really, this year. It was really been cold most of the time, and now all of a sudden, then we got maybe like a week of nice weather. I like the nice spring and fall weather because it's kind of in the middle. It's not too hot, not too cold. And now,
yeah, what happened?
But we only got like a week of that.
And that was it. And now it's summer.
And now we have just blistering heat.
It was earlier this week when I was closing my window at night so I could sleep, and I didn't want to be too cold. And then later that same week, I was dying of heat, literally dying. It's been summer. It's what it's been.
So there you go, weather talk.
Weather talk. Do you like summer, Joe?
I like fall the best, probably, because it's the most consistently decent middle of the... just middle comfortable weather.
I have no strong feelings one way or the other. I'm just kidding. Oh! It's Ori in the Blind Forest. I'm just kidding. It's Ori in the Blind Forest.
We hate it.
No, we love it. We just want to move on. We have a stalker ex-boyfriend. I don't know why I said boyfriend, not girlfriend, but you know what I mean? Like your stalker ex-boyfriend, you just want them to move on because you just want to move on?
Yeah.
You know what that's like, Joe, yeah, right?
We're going to be more careful with how we do LPs in the future. We're gonna get our scheduling better so that we can focus really on one game. Because we've been doing other games too while we're doing this.
I think we could have just made this a wild game, and I would have been okay with that.
Yeah, but we definitely want to finish it now. Not at all that we don't like the game.
Oh, what?
Fucking shit.
I don't know what that was.
Yeah, Ed's playing, if you can tell from the clacking on the controller. Actually, I noticed that when I'm playing, it's usually more clacky than when you're playing, but it's still pretty clacky.
I'm trying to sit away from the mic to lower that.
Should we talk about hard drives and audio equipment?
Yes. Or? Why don't you take the lead on that, then?
Okay, cool. I'll take the lead on that. So, big news on GS. We're probably going to have a video out on this either by the time this video goes out or around the same time.
Yep, we're both gay. That's the news.
What the fuck?
No, that's not true.
Yeah, that's not true, but we got a hard drive.
Yay!
That hard drive that we were having that fundraiser for hard drive and audio.
Fundraiser. Our campaign, our donation.
Our campaign.
Drive.
Yeah, fundraiser. Jesus Christ.
Oh,
we got more than halfway there, so we decided that me and Ed were just gonna split the difference, and just order the hard drive because we really need it, and we've been having enough issues with hard drive space and transferring files every week that we decided that getting it sooner rather than later was better, and each of us putting in 40 or 50 bucks towards it was worth it.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
We just went ahead and got it.
I mean, half of it, or the majority of it, I would say, came from the donations.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. So you guys were a huge help.
Yeah, we couldn't have done it, you know. I wouldn't have wanted to shell out, you know,
the full
price. Yeah. So it was really only possible because of the donations that we got. So thank you. Again?
But
again?
You can hear all that button clacking, and you can hear some background noise, and you might hear a fan humming. I'm not really sure because it's hot.
It's hot. It's hot today.
Yeah, try to stay cool out there, guys.
Pretty much everywhere it's going
to
be hot.
But yeah, that leads me to our other part of the topic, was the other part of our $3 isn't money.
Campaign money. Our Hillary campaign money.
We were trying to get some better audio equipment. We're trying to get another mic so that we can each have a mic. We're recording on one very good mic, but it's only one mic.
You were constantly fighting over it.
We're only one mic. One Ed and one Joe. Yeah, there's a third member of GS. His name is Mike.
Mike. He's a loser.
Yeah.
We never let him on the show.
Yeah, he doesn't say much, but he does. He does record our voices.
He doesn't say much.
This is a dumb bit.
He's never said anything.
But we still need another mic, and we need a mic stand or a mic arm or some kind of a mic setup, and that's going to cost more than the hard drive.
Yeah.
All together for all those items altogether are going to cost more than the hard drive, and that was the other part of our $3 isn't money campaign. So we're still. We're still looking for donations, so if you guys have $3 in your bank account, you're not going to miss it. Just give it to us, please.
Just please. Yeah, I'm going to put out a video on this. Actually, it'll be out before this will.
Okay, so I'll shut up about it. We don't need to push that anymore.
Yeah.
But we did just want to say thanks and that we did get the hard drive. It's a 960 gigabyte solid state drive, so we're doing really well now
as far as
hard drive space goes, and recording quality is going to go for us.
It was such a breath of fresh air to be able to have that much space. So pretty much everything we're going to record now is going to be in the full highest resolution it could achieve. There were some games in the past where we had to scale it down to like 90% of 720 or 90% of 1080.
Have to scale it back a little bit.
Yeah. Just keep the file size manageable.
I had to do that with the Coda Princess episode that we just did. That was actually because I recorded it, though, at my own house.
Oh, yeah, so, you have a small hard drive. You have a super small hard drive.
Yeah, well, I don't have a big SSD. I was recording off of a 10,000 RPM. I was recording onto a 10,000 RPM drive, which is still pretty good, but it's not as good as a solid-state drive, and I just didn't have that much space on the drive, so I had to record it a little bit lower resolution. Well, it's 720 instead of 1080, but Coda Princess is 720 anyway, so you probably won't even notice the difference, because that game runs at 720. Wow.
Birdie.
He's out of here.
He's
good job.
He gave up.
I guess that death wall is gone now, huh?
I would hope so. He just comes back. Oh, look. It's his feathers.
And one feather? That's a nice touch. Maybe you can use that feather to double jump.
Maybe it's like the leaf.
Oh, we can already double jump. And air dash.
Oh, yeah.
Man, game's over. Oh, yeah, there we go.
We need it for us. Oh, it is. It's,
This is exactly like Shantae in the Pirate's Curse. I think it was the same button, too.
Yeah.
The R trigger.
R trigger. Curse feather will out where you glide freely or ride wind current. All right, cool. That's a pretty standard Metroidvania thing. In fact, that's the first ability you get in Dawn of Sorrow for the DS is the abilities. Yeah. Very slow.
Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do. Because that was the one that I played the most, actually.
Oh, okay.
In the first hour or so, particularly.
I think I've played Symphony the most, but I played through that one twice, I think, and I played through Portrait like 3 or 4 times.
Yeah, me too.
So Symphony and Portrait are probably tied for the most played Castlevania games. We're both huge Castlevania fans here.
So there was actually that summer when I was playing Portrait of Ruin. Get this. There was a summer where I was playing Portrait of Ruin and The World Ends With You at the same time. Is that not the best summer you've ever heard?
That's pretty cool.
It's the best. It's the best.
Games.
Yep. Oh, I want to get up there. It was. You know, you ever have a period of your life when you have two games that you want to play?
All the time.
Your biggest problem is that you don't know which one to play? Because you want to play both of them forever?
Right now I have probably about 70 games that I want to play.
Really? Let me guess. Warframe? Sort of,
yeah. That's on the list. That's taking up a lot of my game time now, which is, I would like to cut back on that a little bit because
I'm sorry if I got you.
There's so many other games that I want to play.
Yeah,
but that one's
okay. Birds everywhere.
Particularly addictive, and it's also something that me and my wife can do together because she really likes it probably more than me.
Hey, she's nuts. She's nuts for Warframe.
Yeah. She likes the kind of games with like a lot of progression, and we used to play like Final Fantasy 14 a lot too. And you played that too.
Yeah. Oh, that was the same way.
Yeah, Final Fantasy 14. I'd never really played an MMO. We played a little bit of WoW, like screwed around with it, but I never got max level, and I never really got too into it. But Final Fantasy 14, I guess, was my first real deep MMO, first real deep venture into MMOs, and I really grew to like that game particularly, and I never really got into any other MMOs.
Oh, good. I'm glad this has happened. I can't believe you've done this.
Should we stop for a minute?
Indeed.
I was saying how I'm different. Like, I'm not a racist or a bigot or anything. I just, racial humor's kind of hack anyway. But, you know, I'll say things that are slightly more offensive off the show.
Sometimes. Like what?
Around people that know me well, because
why don't you give
it's
us
hard.
Example.
You gotta get like used to somebody, and it's something like when you first meet somebody. When I first meet somebody, if they come out the gates saying things that are really offensive, I start. that was
what?
That's fair. That seems right.
Yeah.
If somebody just comes out the gates saying things that are offensive or whatever or questionable, then if you don't know them that well, you might actually think that they're a bigot or they're a bad guy, you know? And I feel like the people that are watching GS, especially if they're newer viewers, they're not going to know us that well, and they might actually think that we're bad guys, and I don't want that to happen, you know? Because we're actually nice fellas.
We are.
But me particularly, I have kind of a... Not me particularly that I'm a nicer fellow than you, but
well,
I said me particularly, I'm a meaner guy off the show. I have a little bit of a meaner and offensive sense of humor, I guess.
Oh, that's what you were going to say?
Yeah.
Oh, I guess. I mean, I mean, no. Sorry, I actually can't participate in this conversation while playing the game.
Yeah, that's okay, sorry.
I mean, like, 99% of the people that make those kinds of jokes are not actually saying them. That's why they're making them as jokes and not for real.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I can't do anything right today.
I guess I'd just say, we've talked about this, I think, on previous episodes of this particular game.
Probably, because it's taken 17,000 years.
But just taking risks in comedy, you kind of you have to do it.
Yeah, yeah, you gotta...
And the benefit like, a comedian gets, though, is that everybody kind of gets to know them and know who they are. And also, as a comedian, you're kind of automatically it's kind of automatically assuming that you're joking.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you're not a comedian, or you're not good at making jokes...
Or you're Kramer.
You're an amateur. Yeah, or you're a Kramer, but he's,
Did you say you were Michael a Kramer? Richards,
or... Yeah, yeah, if you're a Kramer.
If you're one of the many thousands of Kramers out there.
If you're Michael Richards. I don't think he was actually a comedian, though. I think he was more of an actor, and then he tried comedy because he wasn't making it as an actor anymore after Seinfeld. And that's why he was so amateur in his handling of that heckler. If you haven't seen Michael Richards' handling of a heckler, his horribly performed handling of a heckler, you can probably see it on YouTube. Just type in Michael Richards heckler.
Be sure that there are children in the room when you do this. Be sure. There must be. So I'm butchering this just horribly. So the gimmick is that you have to use the cape, not the cape, whatever.
A lot of the times with these abilities, they kind of ease into it. But I guess maybe they figure it's later in the game, and you should know how to use abilities by now.
Yeah, I know. Well, they had way too much faith in me.
If this is your first platformer, this might be a little bit tough as a first platformer.
Yeah, because this game is really hard. Yeah.
It's definitely on the harder side. I wouldn't say on the nightmarish difficulty level of a lot of the games that come out now, such as Wings of the...
Oh god, yeah.
Super Meat Boy. They Bleed Pixels, which I never finished. I loved it when we played it on the show, and then I bought it, and we played it on the show, and,
Hey, look at that.
I played it a decent amount after that, and it got, I forget the exact point, but it got tedious to me. It got to a point where it was just too tedious.
Uh-oh.
And I got frustrated and stopped playing.
Where that bird at?
I hear him, and I don't see him. It's getting dark and scary here.
There's a bird. I wonder if he's up here. Is there anything up here? No.
At least you can fall slowly. Oh, okay. It was the first game that had slow falling. Was it Super Mario Bros. 3?
The first game? I don't know,
with
actually.
With the raccoon thing? That's the first game I remember.
That's the first game I remember, too. I don't know if it's... I wonder. That's a good question, actually.
I really want to play Super Mario Bros. 3. I've been wanting to play it on the show for weeks now.
Yeah, we should.
And, like, I feel like I'm going to lose the passion by the time we finally get around to playing it, though.
It's been 20 years. You can last 3 more weeks.
Yeah, it's probably... No, I've played it more recently than 20 years ago.
Well, yeah, I know, but I mean, like... Oh, was it... Where did that come from? I guess it was hidden.
Fucking shit, man.
But then... I'm lost.
Should we stop for a minute?
Look, he's making fun of us. How lost
we're not
we
actually
are.
Lost. Oh. I wasn't looking at the monitor. I was looking away for a second. I just saw you're lost in the woods. There's no map.
No. Is this one of those infinite repeating lost woods type of things?
Oh, boy.
It's the forest maze. It's everyone's favorite part of every game that's ever been made, is the forest maze, right?
Yeah, even Super Mario Brothers had one of those type of things. I think it was the 7th castle. World 7-4, if I remember right.
And Super Mario World, for the Super Nintendo, had an entire world, an entire area that was a forest maze. I think it was called Forest Maze, wasn't it?
Yeah, in Super Mario World. I still forget how to do that. Every time I play the game, I have to look up how to get out of that forest.
It's great. It's a great game, though. Okay.
It is a great game, but that part is a little bit too esoteric.
It's not as bad as Yoshi's Island for Super Nintendo. The second half of the game is cave mazes.
Oh yeah, I remember that. I think I only beat that game once.
Joe and I recently... Yeah.
No. Yeah, it was like a few years ago, right?
We tried to play it together, and getting near the end, it was like climbing a wall, like a rock wall, with no handholds. You can do it.
Basically trying to climb just a solid cement wall, just a regular wall. You ever hear the phrase climbing the walls? It was kind of like that.
Yeah.
It's like going crazy because you're cooped up inside playing Yoshi's Island.
And we should have just gone outside and done other stuff, but, you know. Video games. Video games. Okay.
We love them. You love them. That's why you're watching us play a video game. You love video games so much
that, you not only play video games,
you watch others play them and just ramble over top of it. This episode is going to be a very loose episode of GS.
Aren't they all, though?
Yeah, for the most part, but this one feels particularly loose. We're also drinking heavily.
It's
no, we're not. We're drinking iced tea because it's freaking cold out. I mean, freaking hot
freaking
out.
Freaking cold. Yeah.
It's freaking cold in these glasses, though.
It literally
glasses of iced tea.
It feels like it's August, but it's
well, it's May.
It's almost August, I guess, if you want to look at it that way. But yeah, you're right. So it's May.
Yes. I also refuse to put an air conditioner in.
You're nuts. You're nuts because you're gonna regret it. I'm gonna die.
Until June, which is in 2 days, so it's fine. It's
2 days.
Gonna cool down tomorrow anyway.
Yeah, but if it's 2 days from now, why not just do it now?
No, because that's my rule.
Nah.
My rule is
nah.
That I don't put in the air conditioner until June. Also, we're poor. We have a wall unit air conditioner.
Oh yeah, me too.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean you're poor though. It just means you don't have central air.
Yeah, it does.
What?
Yeah.
No.
You don't have central air, you're poor.
Says who?
Yeah, you stink.
Says you, right?
It says Donald Trump. Oh yeah, we were gonna talk about what was I gonna say about him though? It wasn't political at all. It was the chalking thing that's happening across the nation.
Oh yeah, I don't know about that.
A bunch of schools and stuff. Yeah, there's what do you call it? Mischievous fellas.
Oh yeah?
Some poltergeists. No.
Poltergeists.
So they're human though. They're human.
Oh my god, how did he do that? Alright.
What do you call a mischievous man? I know a mischievous ghost is a poltergeist, but a mischievous man.
A deviant?
I don't know. Yeah, some deviants are taking chalk of all things.
Chalk?
They're not even taking spray paint. They're just taking chalk and writing Trump 2016.
Oh, really?
All across the nation.
That's it?
At schools.
If people are getting upset?
Yeah, I don't remember the original school that happened, but when it happened, like, there was, you know, like these SJWs, these baby types that can't,
They got in an uproar.
Yeah, they whine about everything. Whiners. Professional whiners.
Oh.
They're not really even professionals, though. They just whine.
Oh, Jesus.
But they were getting offended by it and saying that it was, they needed, like, a safe room or something.
A safe room?
But anyway, all it's done is provoked more and more triggerings. Triggering. That's what it's called. It was triggering them. So they wanted to silence They wanted to silence the chalkers from writing the word Trump. Whether or not you like him, I don't know. I think it's funny.
What if they were referring to the Hearthstone Trump?
Yeah, exactly. They could have been... I mean, he's a nice fella. He couldn't possibly offend anyone. Oh, except he recently called out Crip on video.
He did?
Yeah.
Let's talk about it.
Oh, fuck Crip.
Let's
get into our beefs. We've got beefs. Time to bring out the notes here.
Got a lot of beefs to talk about.
What are these?
These
are your old notes.
I've been waiting to use those for about 4 weeks.
I don't think we're ever going to use them. I think we use these up.
Maybe. I don't actually know.
No, these are Knight's notes for about details about Hyper Light Drifter.
Oh, yeah. But at the bottom, there's some notes that we never...
All right. I won't...
Oh, I don't care.
I won't burn your notes.
Nah, whatever. So what do you got to say, though, about...
Yeah, we were going to talk about... We wanted to give some... This actually dovetails perfectly from our Trump topic and our calling out topic.
Oh, yeah.
We wanted to give some nicknames to our other LP channels, the beefs, the ones that we have beefs with.
Because there's a lot of them.
So the first two I just wanted to... I'm basically just copying Donald Trump's nicknames for some of his political opponents. One of our most hated adversaries on GS is Snowman Gaming.
Oh, an adversary he is. Enemies. We're not pals or anything.
So I think Ed decided on this one. Crooked Snowman.
No! That was you. What I did was I put the dollar sign instead of the S.
Oh, yeah. Crooked $$$$
yeah.
No man, which says Crooked Snowman.
Because you know people used to do that with Microsoft? They used to put the dollar sign when they first entered the gaming
also,
market.
Also, the rapper Currency replaces one of his...
Oh, really?
Yeah, but he does it for a cool reason, because he's rich. Because
that's his... Oh, well, because his name is Currency.
Being cool is so awesome. Being rich is so
cool. Being
cool
is so awesome.
Being cool is so rich.
Being cool is so rich. Delicious.
Oh, man.
I'm so lost here. I'm not lost. I know what I'm doing. This game is... It's too hard. It's too hard. But we're not going to quit. We're not quitters.
So, also, the Beard Brothers, they're one of our rivals. They're the Lion Beard Brothers.
L-Y-I-N, not L-I-O-N.
Yeah, Lion.
The Lion Beard Brothers.
There's some lying Leisters, lying men.
Leisters. Yeah.
So we don't like them because they lie a lot.
What did they lie? Do you have an example of what they lied about?
No, I have no example. I have nothing. I'm just copying those ones from old DT Donald Trump.
Oh, all right. That's cool though.
I really like reading Donald Trump's Twitter.
Oh, actually, me too.
I find it to be funny.
That is one of the most entertaining things I've
done.
It's
really in a
long
entertaining.
Time.
Whether or not you like them, I find it to be funny.
Oh, I can't grab those. I thought I could grab those. I can't.
So another one of our rivals. This is another LP channel. His name is HC Bailey, and I call him Idiot Bailey.
No.
Make no sense.
No.
None of these make any sense.
Did you come up with these later night? When did you come up with these? Yesterday, right?
Well, I copied two of them from Donald Trump.
Oh, okay. Because
he uses Crooked and Lion for some of
That's
his
right.
adversaries. But the others I made adversaries. Up. I had to come up with words like idiot.
Idiot. That's more mean-spirited. Well, no, it's not really. Crooked. Crooked is like the mildest way to call somebody a liar, right?
I think so, yeah.
A criminal.
What other ones
do we have
here?
Oh, I did it. I did it. Crooked Lion. What else?
Didn't you have another one for one of our other rivals? That's all the ones I wrote down.
Oh,
I'll think of it later.
I'll have to check my Gmail account. I don't remember.
You had a really funny one, though. Yours was actually funny. It wasn't just adding a word to their name.
I can't remember what it was now. I'd like to know.
Fuck.
If I said something funny, I have to know what it is so I can ride that wave for the next couple of years. You've learned climb. Oh. So we can wall climb and also climb? Check that out. Cool. Oh. Press and hold RT. Oh, this part. So I did actually get to this part when I first played the game. I lied. This is... I remember this as being one of the hardest parts of the game. So, look forward to that. Please look forward to it. Please look forward to it.
I am. And no map. Still no map.
No map still. I think we just have to get out of here. So this section is interesting because, oh god, I can't explain it. I can't explain it and play it the same. Anytime you step on those blue flowers, the configuration will swap to the other configuration. And anytime you jump, I mean, is what I should say.
Oh, see? Okay, I see. That's why it's happening.
So
oh, that's...
It's actually a lot harder because you see this platform and you go, oh, I should probably just jump for that. And you jump into the spikes.
Right.
So it messes with your brain a little bit. You have to jump where there is nothing. So, okay, we're going to try this. We're going to try this and we're going to be successful.
So you can't just jump. What the fuck?
Yeah, I didn't actually
didn't
jump there.
You didn't jump?
Yeah. Accelerated off the edge there. Instead of jumping. Jumping is for losers. Let's see. Yeah, this is trippy. Kind of trippy. There we go.
Speaking of having 70 games that I want to play, I've had Cloud Built.
Cloud Built.
On my hard drive for half a year now. I never played it.
Oh yeah? Do you think you ever will?
Yeah, I bought it when it was on sale a long time ago. Last year. Sometime in 2015.
Is it on Steam?
Yeah. I recommend it highly, even though I've never played it.
I recommend it highly. Okay. We just have a lot of games to play in the future. I don't know if we'll ever have time. I have this backlog of games in case we ever run out of stuff to do. Which is not
going
to happen.
That's not going to happen, though. We have plans for, the next month. And we were going to do a series called Game Soup Arcade, where we play classic arcade games for one credit each and give you guys history on those games.
We're still going to do it, right?
It's going to be, kind of a half-educational, half-goofing series. Yeah, we're still definitely going to do it, but we were originally going to start it probably, a month ago, and it's pushed back to probably at least another month from today. Fucking shit.
Do it all again!
Okay, so we'll just be back in a second.
Okay. Alright, we're in a new section.
Are we back?
Yeah,
we're back. We got it to a new section. This is a little bit lower. Should you make a save point?
Indeed.
You should definitely make a save point.
So, the trick here...
Every time that you jump, it swaps. Yeah.
Okay.
So, if you jump... Okay, so you're going to want to jump again, and now jump.
In fact, I'm glad that they had that platform there so you can save...
Yeah.
No. I have to do this or else I'll die.
Good thinking. I knew I hired you to be the co-host of Game Soup for a reason.
You did.
If you guys didn't know, Joe is actually the boss of Game Soup.
If you didn't know, Joe put actually an ad in the newspaper, because it was a newspaper, not the internet, where he was looking for a co-host.
Yeah, I was looking in the newspaper for a co-host for my internet show called Game Soup. I named it Game Soup. I'm the one that came up with that name.
You are.
But
so one
no,
ad.
No one else. No one else call anything Game Soup.
Ever.
Okay? Don't make a dessert, not a dessert, a recipe called Game Soup. We talked about it already. We're number one on the Google search now, finally.
We earned
the
it.
Words Game Soup.
We earned it. There are slightly more people looking for the Game Soup YouTube channel than there are looking for Game Soup, actual soup, which is nice. It's a good feeling to have when you just barely beat out a soup.
An actual soup.
He put up a good fight, but you know what, in the end...
Yeah, in the end, we're much better than a roasted bird in boiling water. Is that funny? No, not really.
What is... Did you like the old man voice that I put on at the end of the analysis video?
Yeah, I loved it.
What is Game Soup, anyway? Boiling plastic and circuitry?
Yeah, go check that out if you haven't seen it yet. It's quality content.
It's the Dark Souls... Oh, I want to get in there! Dark Souls top 5 level design moments. I found an online text-to-speech thing. I love playing with those. And I found a really interesting one this time. And it has a really cool old man voice at the end of the video. Oh, he's gonna shoot me!
Game Soup, dudes.
Game fucking soup, dudes. Trying to avoid swearing on the show because, you know, that's on the internet forever. Just forever. And what if I want to be president someday? And they say, listen to these hateful things that... Listen to those hateful things that President... Well, I almost said my last name, too.
That's...
Well, no, it's not. It's just like...
I think they could probably find your name and address if they really wanted to. So get searching, fellas.
Oh, I'm just going to kill myself. Get searching. You know, the thing is, somebody will do it. Somebody. The thing is...
I want to get a P.O. box.
Oh, it costs money, though.
Yeah, it costs money. I don't want to...
Do we need it?
Yeah. That's another thing I was thinking about. How are we both so smart and still so poor?
I'm lazy. I don't know about you.
Yeah, I guess. I guess I'm kind of lazy, but... I didn't used to be. I was, like, on the rise, and now I'm, not.
Warframe is what happened. We should sue Digital Extremes for making us poor.
Yeah.
Do you think that would work?
I'm really good at getting rich in video games. Like, I figured out the system in Final Fantasy XIV, and I became a mogul.
Seriously,
in Final Fantasy XIV, and then I'm doing the same thing with Warframe. If I could just translate that skill to real life, I'd be a millionaire.
It has to translate somehow. You made so much money in Final Fantasy XIV. Okay, I think I'm just going to die here. I can't save. Can I get up there? Here we go.
The real world paralleled virtual worlds in some way.
So you're saying it doesn't...
If only supply and demand transferred to the real world.
Alas, they don't. Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm rich in platinum.
Gotta get that plat, and I am too. That's a very capitalist thing to do, is
to... Am I rich in dollars? No.
No. You can sell plat for dollars on some illicit website.
Yeah, I guess you could, but I think that the amount of time that takes is probably not worth it.
Oh no, there's nothing down here. Oh, yeah, you're right. You're absolutely right. Plus, you get your
trade it for
banned.
Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a ridiculous price right now.
I know.
I checked it before I came over here. It's ridiculous.
Bullshit. It makes me salty, though. It makes me salty because the Bitcoin price has been essentially unchanged for the last 6 months. What?
Yeah.
And the day after I used Bitcoin to make a slightly moderate-sized purchase, the price jumped $100 up. Like, that is quintessential Bitcoin.
Yeah.
That is exactly what will happen. Anytime you use Bitcoin, the price is going to jump the next day. Spike. Skyrocket.
And anytime that you sell it... Actually, I've been pretty good about when I buy and sell. I guess that's something that I can make money on, that I have made money on in real life.
Yeah, that's true. Investments are some of the hardest things to make money on,
in fact. I'm pretty good at... But I don't really know how to work the stock market, but I know how to work Bitcoin. I've been pretty good about buying low and selling high. It's pretty easy. You just watch when it goes way high up and then starts to go down a little bit, that's when you sell. Right when it starts to go down a little
bit.
You won't get as much as if you sold when it was high, but it might have kept going higher. So you just sell when it goes down a little bit, and then you buy not when it hits the bottom, but when it starts bouncing up a little bit. And that's all you have to do. I haven't made a huge ton of money, but I've made a little bit.
Also, the trick to investing on the stock market with success
is don't do it because it's fucking rigged.
Well, yeah, that too, but I was gonna say, I mean, is just to buy anything that people will always need as long as they live on planet Earth. Examples: housing, food.
Oh yeah, if you buy like property, that's kind of a tried and true method of,
well, that too, yeah,
but that's for, you have to make a bunch of money before you do that. I don't have enough money to buy property.
How do I do it?
I guess. Can you get over to the other side first?
Teaches how to blitz.
Yeah, yeah. I think you don't think you have to shoot it.
Oh, there's no trick. There's no trickery right up. Trickery.
This one you might have to play a trick.
We're gonna trick this one. Yeah, the trick to making long-term investments is that they're gonna take a long time.
But we're giving we're giving investment advice after we just finished complaining that we're poor.
I know, it's great, isn't it? So if anybody listens to us and makes money, let us know how you did. And if you actually listen to us.
Did you get a job? Because that probably was a good first step, because I haven't done that in quite some time. But, I mean, I've worked. I do a lot of work, actually. But I do my own stuff, and it's kind of scary, because it doesn't always pan out. But, you know, I haven't had to get a job in the last... How long has it been? Like 7 years, so...
Don't say that. People are going to regret giving us donations.
Yeah. But, well, I'm not completely lazy. Just work for myself and don't have a job. It's pretty nice.
Yeah, yeah.
But there's a lot of crappy parts about it too, and it's
that's an important clarification to make. Is that
it can be more stressful in a lot of ways, because
there's
some months where you're not quite sure if you're gonna make it.
Is this the way we came?
No,
this is new, right?
This is new.
Yeah, it's important clarification to make is that it's not that you don't have a job because you're lazy. It's that because you work for yourself. You're self-employed.
Yeah.
And you can see his work at redtube.com.
What? You mean redbubble.com?
No. Oh, yes, that's what I meant.
Redbubble is a website where you can post your artwork, and they put it on shirts and other products. Redbubble.com... /57? No, I think... I can't remember the fucking address.
That's
going to send me a check every month, and I haven't.
It's going to be.
I'm
going to
be updating it pretty soon, though. Actually, in the next month or so.
If you like video game gear,
a lot of new artwork,
stickers, and such, right?
Yeah, I think it's 57mediastore.redbubble.com.
Ah,
it might be 57media.redbubble.com, but
Redbubble.
It's one of those two. I think it's actually just 57media.redbubble.com. I don't know.
You should get the website, 57media.com.
It's mostly older stuff on there, though. I'm a little bit of a better artist now, but I haven't updated it in like a year, so. But I will be very soon.
You should get the website, redbubble.com/biz3/Pokemon City. Would you like to do that?
Didn't you have a website called Pokemon City?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This has been the worst day of my life.
Well, you've had a pretty sweet life.
Yeah, that's
sweet,
actually
bro.
True.
I've been saying sweet bro constantly when we're in our G-chats. Whenever Ed says something cool or something great happened, I say sweet bro.
Or you can use it sarcastically, right?
Yeah, I guess.
It's the phrase with infinite uses.
And then it makes me think of Sweet Bro and Hella Jeff, and I start linking you to Sweet Bro and Hella Jeff comics,
which I
kind of hate, but I kind of like at the same time.
I enjoyed you linking.
Yeah.
Or I enjoyed you making the reference.
Post your favorite Sweet Bro and Hella Jeff comic in the comments below if you're into that webcomic.
We need to get our attack up. We are so weak right now. We are so weak.
Yeah, we're not doing enough damage.
Damage. Oh, not the charge flame. Not with the
charge flame. Charging isn't as fun as quick flame. Split flame. Wait, what's split flame?
Spirit flame to damage two targets at once.
That's really good. I think we need to work towards that.
Well, we don't have to work very hard. Look at that little sliver of XP that we need.
All right, let's
get
it.
We're pretty much ready to get it. We just
have
to kill.
Get it going.
Slaughter one more innocent creature and we're good to go. Here's a question. What's the worst day of your life? Can you relive that for us and post it in the comments? Share your most intimate secrets with us?
I'm not going to talk about the worst day of my life.
Oh, just for the watchers, I guess.
Yeah, you guys talk about
it. And if you want to share, you don't have to share. I mean, who's going to force you, you know?
I've had some bad days. I think everybody's had some bad days.
Yeah. If you want to share the worst experience of your life, the worst, like, 24 hours or... I don't know.
Tell us. That's such a terrible topic.
It is?
Yes.
Okay, we'll go the other direction. Tell us about the best 24 hours of your life.
Tell us about your favorite game, or your favorite moment of Ori and the Blind Forest.
But only from GameSoup's Let's Play, and from no other channel.
Okay, yeah. Speaking of other channels, what are some of our other rivals? I keep trying to... You had a really funny one before we...
We have to look it up. Should we look it up?
Yeah. Okay, and we're here again.
We back never went away.
We're gonna continue the topic of giving nicknames to all of our rivals and friends.
Oh dear lord.
So what about Lobos Jr.? What would you like to call him?
I would like to call him Blobos.
Oh, I thought it was Bobo's
Jr. Oh, yeah, it was. Sorry. Bobo's.
Bobo's Jr.
Bobo's Jr.
Okay, so that's Lobo's Jr. Who else do we have here? Game Maker's Toolkit?
Oh, yeah, I like this one. I called him Game Maker's Fool Kit.
Yeah, so screw you.
Like, what did he ever do to us? Nothing.
Yeah, but
nothing.
But we don't like him. We pretend. He's one of the ones we pretend to don't like.
There are so many people that we pretend not to
like. Here's a guy that we actually don't like, though. You know Kriparian, the Hearthstone player?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, fuck him.
Did you make up a name for him?
Yeah, yeah, Wobbly Head Moron Krip.
Is that a thing that he does?
Yeah, wobbly head. Because he has kind of a big wobbly head. He kind of looks... Never mind, I don't want to get too... No, let's be mean. He kind of looks like he kind of looks like an ugly Tom Selleck.
Yeah, he does, doesn't he?
Yeah. Like Tom Selleck had a big round head. He actually kind of does, though. But he's not handsome, you know?
Yeah.
I don't understand why anyone likes Krip.
So me neither.
If you're a fan of Krip, clip this and send it to him. Or just whatever, link it.
If you're a fan of Krip, Krip this.
Yeah, Krip it. Crip it and send it to him. I want to start beefs with him.
Yes.
You know, we don't like him.
You know, someday we're going to meet these people if we get big enough. Do you think?
I don't know. If we meet Crip, you know, I'm going to apologize profusely.
Oh, yeah.
And act really fake around him and be very friendly and just...
I would hope that he knows we're just joking.
Well, actually, I'm not joking. I really don't like him. I think he's a salty and mean kind of guy. But he acts like he's nice on his episodes. And when he starts the episode,
The funniest thing
he says, his intro to the episodes is you can't understand what he's saying.
Yeah, but you know what? We also have an intro that's similar to "Hey, it's hello and welcome to Game Soup."
Sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes, but not every time. Actually, right, cool. However, I will defend him by saying that the funniest thing that he ever did unintentionally was that YouTube poop that I saw recently,
where he talks about cards.
This card is a card.
Card over and over again.
Yeah, this card is really a card, funny. And that kind of makes it a bad card.
But he didn't make that, did he?
No, he was just featured in it. Yeah. He wasn't actually.
That was fan made. That was basically making fun of him, which is really why I liked it. I really just want to rub that in his face. I hope he got really mad about that video.
Yeah.
And was he probably laughed? I'm sure he has a sense of humor.
I have never enjoyed Krip more than that moment.
Yeah.
I actually cried with laughter that day.
I don't know. I don't understand why anybody likes him. I don't hate him so much that I want to, like, bring... I don't want to hurt him, but... I just find him to be... I don't know. There's just something about him. He rubs me the wrong way.
What is it?
Anyway? But, you know, Trump... Trump is very nice. But Trump, to me, feels... I think Trump is genuinely a nice guy. And he's not faking it. I think Trump is being himself. And I think that's why I like Trump. Trump the Hearthstone player.
Yeah, not Donald Trump
not
this
Donald
time.
Not Donald Trump.
One of the few times we're not talking about Donald Trump, the presidential candidate. How do I get in there? I guess I can't.
So who else do we hate and want to give... who else do we have beefs with? Oh, Mr. Happy. He's a Final Fantasy XIV and other game player. He's mainly a Twitch streamer. We wanted to call him Loser Mr. Happy.
That's not even clever.
Yeah, no, it's not. I mean, then you could go with the obvious Mr. Crappy, but we decided to go with an even less clever Loser Mr. Happy.
Yeah, why didn't we just call him Mr. Crappy, though?
I don't know.
It just rolls off the tongue. All these have good insults that just roll off the tongue.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, they sure do. So we're sort of making fun of Donald Trump's insults here in a way, too, because he gives his opponents stupid names.
Right? Oh.
Did you know gaming?
Oh, yeah. Did you blow gaming?
Yeah.
I liked that one. How come all of my insults have to do with blowing?
I don't know, man.
They're all Blobos Jr. Oh, Bubos. Bobos Jr.
Bobos Jr.
And then did you blow gaming and then Toolmaker's Blow Kit. Oh,
and Angry Joe. We mentioned it when we actually hate them. And of these, we actually... Well, Krip we kind of half hate. And Angry Joe, I legitimately hate. I can't stand the fella.
I agree.
So
our nickname
for him is Fake Not Actually Angry Joe.
Yeah, that's a good one.
He came out shortly after the Angry Nintendo Nerd, and I think he was trying to capitalize on the angry at video games.
Oh, is that why?
Oh, yeah.
Along the same line, you know who I loathe? Probably more than anybody I've ever seen on the internet.
Nostalgia Critic.
Oh, yeah, you're
right. Fuck that
right.
guy, too. We should
you're
Nostalgia
right.
Critic, more like the...
There's another one, though.
Just a big jerk. It's a big jerk Nostalgia Critic.
Well said.
Dumbhead Nostalgia Critic.
There's one more person, though, who tried to ride that AVGN wave.
Oh, who's that?
The Irate Gamer.
Oh, I've heard of that guy.
I'm glad you haven't seen it, then.
I've heard the name, but I haven't seen it.
Yeah. Wait, what is this? The Guma on sale. Forlorn Ruins.
Yeah, but Angry Joe, he's just an act, and... when he does videos, he does like these visual gags, and he takes a bunch of time like making costumes and props sometimes for them. And,
I appreciate that.
But he lets the footage play for way too long. What should be a 3-second gag, he lets go for like a minute and a half. It's sort of like the first time somebody recorded a rap song, but they were playing it on a guitar and doing like a folk version of a rap song.
Yeah.
Like, you could see how that could be funny maybe in like 1993 and maybe for like the first 20 seconds of the song. Like, you'd be like, oh, that's funny. I haven't seen that happen before. You know, somebody's playing a genre of music and they're not actually a rapper and they're doing a foolish job of it and they're playing it on a guitar. And you might get a chuckle, you know, for the first 20 seconds of the song. But 40 seconds into the song, you're really sick of it. And then the next time someone does that gag, you cringe because it's so old and it became hack 20 seconds into the first time. And we're in 2016 now, and fellas like Nick Offerman and these other guitar fellas are making these rap covers.
Don't you dare talk ill of Nick
Offerman. Oh boy, this is where we're going to differ. I'm not a fan of this Offerman fella. He is one of the fakest of the fake.
I'm gonna kill you.
He is an act. He is not a manly guy. Not at all. He is a bitch.
What happened? Tell me your story. You have a story, obviously, that goes along with this.
He travels the country with his wife doing covers of rap songs, thinking that it's clever and funny. He's not good.
Most people disagree with you, though.
A lot of people would disagree with me, but he is a fake, a fraud, and a loser. Maybe not a loser, because he's made a lot of money, and I like people that made a lot of money, but he's a complete fake. He is not this character that he's portraying.
Wait, what is this? Press X to interact with the Shrouded Lantern.
And even beyond just him, even if everybody is in on it and knows he's not a character, he's like the opposite of this character.
You know, he built a boat.
I don't care. He's not that guy.
What do you mean he's not that guy? What guy is he pretending to be?
He's pretending to be like this woodsman fella. And he's trying to
become
this.
Is that because you've seen Parks and Rec?
But it's.
That's his character in Parks and Rec.
Yeah, that's his character.
He's an actor, man.
But he acts like that. And didn't he like write a book about it? About being a man? People like him because he's like an example of a manly guy. He's not, though.
He's kind of a comedian.
And he's not a good comedian either. Sorry, his act is very cringe. It's not for me.
This is the last episode of Game Soup.
This is something we disagree on. We almost always agree on everything, Ed and I. But this Nick Offerman fella, not gonna happen. It's never gonna happen for me.
Where did you first hear about him?
Parks and Rec.
Did you watch Parks and Rec?
Not very much. I've seen a little bit.
You don't like it that much?
Not that much. I guess it's fine. I guess it's clever. I don't know. But I didn't really get that into it. I like Nathan For You, Rick and Morty, and there's not that many TV shows that I really watch that much anymore. I'm not one of these guys that's like, I hate TV and I'm above watching TV. I like TV shows and I like watching TV.
Well, Joe, let me just say that you have very particular tastes.
I do have very particular tastes. There's a lot of humor that comedians I don't like. I like Ari Shaffir.
I don't know who that is. I don't know who that is. I do not. And most people might disagree with you on some points.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely.
I gotta get out of here.
And I welcome that. I mean, it's. If you want to like Nick Offerman, I'm not gonna fault you, but I'm just expressing my distaste for him and his wife. I forget his wife's name, though.
I don't know. She was... Jesus Christ.
That'll come through on the microphone really loud.
That's okay. What if I just didn't edit anything this week? Everything went out exactly as it is now?
Okay.
Oh, we wouldn't have a show anymore.
We would, and it would be...
Don't say it'd be better.
It wouldn't be better than you editing out the deaths and the parts where we pretty much don't talk, but...
Oh, yeah.
I think they could scrub ahead, or... There's not that many people. Nobody's watching this.
Yeah, I know. That's the thing, though. If nobody's watching it, why even continue?
But there is somebody watching it. And, you know, when we first started, really nobody was watching it, and we kept doing it anyway. You gotta build from somewhere, but...
Yeah, I guess
we also should probably respond somewhat to our viewers. we want to do what we want to do, but if we're not even enjoying doing the Let's Plays, then and nobody's watching it, that's a pretty bad recipe right there.
Yeah, that's a pretty bad recipe for game soup, you might say.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I didn't even mean to do it like that.
But it's the soup that we're beating on Google.
I guess we're doing pretty good, though, now, so we're probably going to keep that little joke in there, right?
What joke? Yeah, yeah, oh yeah.
That GS.
Our soup joke? Because we're so clever about soup.
Yeah. So the wobbly head fucking moron Crip.
Wobbly.
What were we even talking about?
Mapstone fragment. We were talking about,
people that we, don't.
Yeah.
That are rivals.
Yeah. Who else is a rival for?
I think that was it. I think Angry Joe was the last one. And he was capitalizing on the angry guy.
Yeah.
The angry video game nerd. And here's why I don't like, or here's why I do like Angry Nintendo Nerd. He was the first to do, at least the first to get recognition of being the angry guy about classic video games.
Okay.
He was very clear that he was playing a character, and he also posted videos where he's being James. He's being real,
yeah.
And he's done other video work. He's most famous for playing the character Angry Video Game Nerd. He's very good at it, and the videos are funny pretty consistently. I mean, it's been a long time, so they're... It's a lot of similar gags over and over again. I'll admit that, but I still do enjoy Angry Nintendo Nerd or Angry Video Game Nerd.
How do we shot web?
Can you air dash in, then double jump, and then
yes,
wall climb to get out?
Yes, but we don't have any saves, so I'm gonna skip it for now and come back.
Okay.
Sorry. What were you saying?
I don't know, I was just saying that the difference between Angry Joe and Angry Video Game Nerd is that one is real and one is fake.
It's very clear that he's acting.
That's kind of the theme of this episode, is real versus fake. And even earlier I talked about how I guess everybody's guilty of being fake to some extent. Because not fully myself when we're doing Game Soup, because I do hold back a little bit.
I think the most important factor is that we are the real Game Soup now.
Yeah.
That's like the only thing that kind of matters.
Yeah, we are the only Game Soup.
Yeah,
what does that matter? That was a good death.
What does it matter again? I don't know.
Chicken biscuits?
It's called chicken in a biscuit.
Chicken in a biscuit?
Yep. Have you ever had chicken in a biscuit, Joe?
No.
I know the answer is no, because we talked about
this
before
the show.
We talked
about it, and I wanted to know what it was, but we decided to save it for the show. So what exactly is it?
Okay, so it's sort of like Ritz crackers. Ritz crackers are delicious. Chicken in a biscuit is delicious. Because... Oh, God, he exploded. Because when they make it with chicken broth. You know, it's a cracker, but it has chicken broth in it. So just imagine, if you will, a delicious Ritz cracker, very buttery. That also tastes like
I'm laughing
like
as far
chicken.
Away from the mic as I can so I don't spike our volumes.
Oh, how do I get... How? This is not possible.
Yeah, I think I'm going to buy it next time I'm at the...
You should.
I try not to buy crackers because I don't like eating just junky snack foods. I try to keep that shit out of the house. But
yeah, it is kind of junky, but it's delicious. You won't regret it. You will not regret it.
But yeah, I might. Because last time I bought a... We talked about every topic on the show. But
yeah.
Last time I bought a box of Cheez-Its, it was probably like at least a year ago at this point. But I ate like half the box in one sitting, and I just felt disgusting.
Oh,
They taste so good. God. They're like formulated to be really delicious. It's like McDonald's. Well, actually, McDonald's isn't that delicious. But it's kind of like formulated to be just really salty and make your tongue get really excited from the taste of salt. It really works.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, anything that's salty is delicious to some... Oh, you can use these guys to... okay, I see.
But, like, really good cooking is a little more subtle. Like the way that we used to make chicken wings. Before Game Soup...
Subtle!
Before Game Soup, we used to have a thing called Chicken Night.
Okay.
That Ed and I did once a week.
Yeah, it was very subtle.
And Ed would come over to my house, and we would make chicken wings, or sometimes other kinds of chicken, but usually wings, and we would cover them with Frank's Red Hot. Or whatever hot sauce we had, and lots of salt, right? Was it just plain salt, or did we...
We would
brine it in soy sauce.
Yeah, we'd brine it.
And then put salt on it, too, I think.
Seasoning. Mostly
seasoning.
Seasoning.
Yeah, that's right.
It wasn't just
it
pure
was like,
salt.
Yeah, it was a Montreal steak seasoning, which has a lot of salt in it.
Yeah, that's the one.
And coconut... We would cook it in coconut oil and...
Coconut flakes.
And coconut flakes on the top.
That was the best... food I ever had. Probably.
Really good.
Probably,
but
yeah.
But extremely overpowering flavor.
Oh, yeah.
Like, salty and spicy all at once. It was basically an assault on your tongue.
It's everything you could want.
And it's not... It's definitely not a recipe for everyone, but that's how we used to make chicken wings. So we would eat chicken wings and watch TV shows, and then we would play games.
Do you like spicy foods? If so, do it.
So this is basically chicken night, minus the chicken, but plus recording it.
Plus recording it. Yeah, you're right. So it's not chicken night at all, actually, then.
No, there's no chicken involved.
So when you say this is chicken night...
We should have called our channel Chicken Night.
Oh.
It's not too late to change the name of it.
Did I just die?
No.
Wait, what is happening?
Oh, you can swim down there and get that glowy.
Yeah, but...
Get that shiny.
You're right. I can just get it.
Get that shiny, you bitch.
Get that shiny.
This is the last episode of Game Soup for sure, because we've disagreed on so many topics, and I just called Ed a bitch.
You did, and you've never done that.
Actually, I apologize for that. That wasn't funny. That was just pretty rude.
It was uncalled for.
Yeah, it was uncalled for and rude.
I'll accept your apology.
Even if I'm joking, it's like... And also, if you do offend somebody with the joke, and nobody laughs, then you should apologize. Not for being offensive, but because you made a bad joke and you made everybody cringe.
More than anything, you should just apologize for making a bad joke then, you think?
Yeah, I try to apologize when I make a bad joke, but, you know, there's so many that I can't apologize for all of them. So this is an apology for all the bad jokes before and all that are to come. So now I'll never have to apologize again.
Oh, that's like kind of a cop-out.
Yeah, it's kind of a cop-out. I'll try to apologize.
No, you shouldn't. It takes up too much brain power.
Okay.
It takes up way too much time. I would like to save my progress in this game, but we haven't hit up a save point anytime recently.
Yeah, let's just be careful.
It's this game. Do you know what game we're playing?
Oh, good. Ruins.
Forlorn.
Nothing ever crumbles beneath you and causes a cheap death like ruins.
Never. Oh, no. It's Forlorn. I wonder how long this episode is so far.
We're making a double app, though.
We are, but...
Maybe we should have announced that at the beginning, but you can probably see that it's a double app. There is a point where we're probably going to take a break so that we can continue being entertaining and also good at the game. So if you're starting to lose your ability to maintain, I guess?
I think we should look to exit out in like the next 10 minutes or so.
Okay, cool. What's this thing?
Oh, it's another light bomb. Light bomb from Dragon Ball Z. Use the light vessel to activate and walk over Gumon structures without... What?
That doesn't look like a Gumon structure, I think. You're walking over the wall.
It's gravity, man. It's a VV... No.
No, it's sideways, though.
Oh,
it's not up and down. VVV, that's a great example of a game that just used one mechanic over and over and just perfected and did all kinds of different things with one little mechanic.
I would still like to save my progress, though.
It's like a condensed form of nice game design.
Yeah, it is pretty nice.
Game like VVVVV, like six Vs.
I don't know. Is it six? I don't even know.
Yeah, it is. It's six because there's six main characters and they all start with V. I learned that from a commenter on our VVVV video many months ago.
Oh, I'm in the ceiling. How do I get down?
You can't walk down that side? Yeah.
I can't.
You can't walk on that wall. Oh.
I'll just drop it and then I'll be fine, right? Wait, what?
Soul Link is ready.
Is it just following us? It's just following us. Okay, that's cool.
So yeah, you can just carry it around.
Yeah, let's save first though. Let's save first and get a new ability. Let's get... Oh, we can't get it. What can we get? We can get Ultra Spirit Magnet. I guess we'll just hang on for now. Joe. It's been a rough day. By rough, I mean not rough.
It hasn't been particularly rough.
I would just like to finish the game.
Yeah.
God, I hope that this is not just us complaining about this game.
We do like the game. We actually really like
it. I really love this game. I want to play it at my leisure.
It's really hard.
Yeah. No more hard games.
We had a commenter on an earlier video say maybe that we should play games that we're more familiar with as LPs, and I tend to agree with that.
Yeah, I do too.
But our next two LPs, we will not be following that advice. But the one after that, I think we will.
I think those are exceptions. I think I'm willing to make those exceptions.
Yeah.
Well, I know about one of them. Mighty Number 9 is the one.
Yeah, Mighty Number 9. We're just playing that out the gate. We're gonna record that the day it comes out.
We need to catch that hype train. You know.
Yeah. Well. Yeah. Maybe just to catch the hype train, just because it's new, and also I'm very excited about the game. Yeah, we're both very excited about.
It's gonna
Mighty
be awesome.
Number 9.
Even if the marketing and development have... Oops.
Do you think they did that marketing, like, as really cringe as possible on
Not
purpose?
Not everything is cringe! No, I don't think they did it on purpose. I don't think they did it on purpose.
Well, that's definitely, like, the definition of cringe, though, that marketing.
Well, yeah,
that marketing.
But, okay. Yeah, but I don't
A lot of things are cringe. But
You love cringe. You
I
love
do
talking
like
about
certain,
cringe.
Certain kinds of cringe I love. There's actually two kinds of cringe. There's when someone is trying to be funny and fails...
Ooh.
That's a bad kind of cringe.
Okay.
So, a lot of our jokes on games. But when there's a really awkward situations that are created intentionally or even not intentionally, but we know that it's awkward. For instance, the television program Nathan for You.
You love that show.
Which is why I love this show so much.
Okay, this is like the 8th time I've done this. There we go.
He finds the best people to be on that show. He knows how to find a fool, basically. Like, how to find somebody that's really gonna...
What? Oh, I shouldn't have jumped
That's
back.
Really gonna make some cringe moments happen. So that's an example of good cringe.
Go to cringe.com.
Like the situations on that show just make... Yeah, they make you... Ooh.
What?
Watch the... if you haven't seen the show before, watch the exorcism episode. The home realtor exorcism episode. Have you seen it?
I have seen it.
Yeah, yeah, it's great.
Yeah, I can't watch that show, though.
Yeah, some people can't watch it. It's too much for some people, but it's just the perfect amount for me.
Whatever that thing is called, sympathetic embarrassment.
Sympathetic embarrassment, yeah, there's a lot of that.
I can't do it. I can't watch anything like that. Come on, I don't want to die again. Come on. There we go.
But I get, like, sympathetic embarrassment, like we were talking about earlier, like, people doing guitar covers of rap songs.
Yeah.
I find that to be a bad hack, and if you're, like, making an entire career out of doing that, I don't know, man. It's not for me. I guess some people don't cringe at it. I don't know, but to me, that's about as cringe as it gets.
You also listen to rap music.
I do, and I find it to be disrespectful. Like, I think it was probably funny the first time somebody did it, and I might have even thought it was funny the first time. I can't remember the first time I heard it. But to do it again and again, and to do it for an entire song, and to do it over and over again.
You're describing rap, right? What are you describing?
I'm describing...
Because that's what rap
guitar
is.
Covers. Yeah, of course. It's a genre of music. You're doing you're doing the same kind of... You could say that about rock music or punk rock or blues or anything, right?
Yeah, but rap is made up typically... Well, I shouldn't even say this. I don't know if this is true or not. But you always hear samples that are like 5 seconds long and they just play over and over and over and over and over until you go insane.
It's changed a lot. It's evolved quite a lot over the last... Well... It's still a newer genre of music. I mean, it's 30 or 40 years old at this point, but it's still... Everything hasn't been done, and there's still a lot of experimentation going on. So I really like it, and it's probably... It's the only genre that I follow new music pretty religiously. Like, I used to listen to a lot, all kinds of music, new music, old music, and I tried to be, like, eclectic, you know?
Yeah.
Different taste in music, and... I was a music guy. I pretty much listened to music all day back then.
Oh, what is going to happen here?
And I got into, like, jazz and heavy metal and all kinds of rock music, hip-hop, rap, everything. Pretty much any kind of music, but the one genre that kind of stuck, that's kind of stuck over the years that I always go back to is, like, hip-hop and rap music. So, I don't know. It's just constantly evolving. It's constantly interesting.
I have a good idea.
What's up, man?
CareDash.
Pretty good idea.
Right?
Without carrying the thing with you?
No, that was a bad idea. No, it follows you.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Oh.
Fucking shit, man.
Yeah.
Should we stop for a minute?
Nah.
All right.
We're good. We're good.
Oh yeah, but I was just saying, like, yeah, it is kind of disrespectful to keep doing it when it's not funny. And
well, that's only you though. Some people do think it's funny. Some people think that Nathan for You is not funny at all. And that's hack.
I guess it's not for me. No. No one could possibly think Nathan for You is hack. Hack is not the right word. Not like, fine. Cringe, of course. But hack, no. No. Nathan for You is on the cutting edge of comedy.
That's an opinion, though, man. Just cutting edge. No, it's
cutting edge. Who's done it before? Hack means somebody's done it before.
I don't know every actor or entertainer that's ever done anything like that. There might be one. I don't know.
I've never seen it.
Just because you haven't seen it doesn't make it not hack. You know what I'm saying? It might exist. It might be out there.
Okay, but we're not gonna get anywhere with this.
You know what I'm saying, though?
We're not gonna get anywhere because anything could possibly exist.
Yeah, that's true. Like anything could possibly.
So we have to have some kind of a ground. Some kind of ground to stand
on.
The two of us, I don't think either of us has ever seen anything like Nathan for You. If you've seen anything like it and you think that it's hack and you think he's ripping someone else off, post it below.
In the comments.
You don't have to like him, but there's no way I'm going to argue that there's no way that a show like Nathan for You is hack at all. It's one of the most creative and cool shows on television
what?
Right now.
What about Lost?
I don't know.
Did you see Lost?
Nah.
You're missing out.
I don't think so.
You're like I don't know anybody. Well, I shouldn't say that. Most people. Oh, okay. This is really hard. It's really hard to make a jump like that.
Oh. Are you holding left?
Yeah. You keep left and right. You don't actually have to change.
You don't press
it's
up.
It's messed
go.
Up. Yeah. It's so messed up.
That seems difficult.
It's hard because of that.
Should we stop for a minute?
No, we'll just keep going. I'll just edit that later.
Okay.
Nobody will ever know. Nobody will know what's happening.
They won't hear our argument about what's cringe and hack.
Yeah.
They won't?
Well, no, they
won't. I want them to hear that. I want them to hear our disagreements. Because we're almost always on the same page on GS. Because, well, we talk about game design a lot, and we're both have very similar taste in game design and very similar views on game design. We have very similar views on a lot of other things, but...
Most things.
But music and comedy, I guess. Quick. Yeah, let's do an outro.
Welcome to the House of 1,000 Deaths.
So the moral of today's episode was... Joe and Ed disagree and hate each other.
Craparian.
That's good.
Right?
Yeah, we do agree on the YouTube fellas that we hate and pretend to hate, though.
Yeah, that's true. Although most of them are hack. Such as the Irate Gamer and Nostalgia. What's his name? Nostalgia Critic?
Yeah, Nostalgia Critic, Irate Gamer, Angry Joe, they're all we can agree on hack. So this has been kind of a polarizing episode between Ed and I, and I'm sure that we've polarized some of you out there, some of you guys that are watching, so leave a comment. We would like to have a discourse. We would like to have disagreements with some of our viewers. We can't always agree on everything.
We try, though.
We're probably not going to have a comment war with you or a comment off, you know, like a response back and forth. I don't like to take a lot of time posting comments on the internet, but maybe we'll address some of the comments. And if you post a really offensive one or maybe a really polarizing issue in the comments, maybe we'll make it a comment of the week or something to make it a discussion.
Say something extremely offensive to everybody, to as many people as possible.
Yeah.
And then we'll definitely...
Well, there was that one time Joe and Ed did 9/11. That was one of the more offensive things anyone's ever said to me.
Yeah, but it was backwards.
That'd be really funny.
You know, it was well hidden.
Yeah.
Sort of.
Anyway... We were trying to outro the app.
Goodbye.